Hello, and welcome to a quick overview of Banjo-Kazooie on Rare Replay. This is a game that came out in 2008 for the Xbox 360, and we are playing the Rare Replay version, which is on the Xbox One. I'm just going to press the Xbox button to show that this is on the Xbox One. And so, if I press Windows key and hamburger, I bring up the Xbox 360 menu. So how this works is the Xbox Microsoft developed an emulator for the Xbox 360 on the Xbox One, and then it downloads a wrapper, and then the Xbox One thinks it's playing an Xbox 360, which is Xbox One thinks Xbox 360 is a game, and then it runs from there. It's all sorts of complicated. There's a good article from Digital Foundry about this stuff, but I never played the 360 version, this game is decent. It does something really interesting, which you can create vehicles, but this version of the game, this backwards compatibility version, I don't like it. It runs into serious frame rate issues that actually give me a headache. I don't know if this is an Xbox 360 also had that, but it's in the town here, it is just like really crappy frame rate. It's gonna be really hard to see on the capture, but it's not pretty. It's kind of a bad experience, and it just makes me think, like, so a lot of people don't have access to backwards compatibility. It's technically still in beta, but this game is retail, and it's just not a fun experience. It's really, it's not like, you know, Xbox One, Xbox original games on 360. This is kind of emulated in software. It's not emulated in hardware. There is no hardware chip on the Xbox One. It's a completely different architecture, so it's a lot harder to do. But they've done it. This is not the best version of this game. Like, I would really like to play this game on the 360 and see how that is, but this is the Xbox One version. That being said, this game's also kind of mediocre. It came out, I don't remember the reviews. At the time, I didn't have an Xbox 360, but a lot of people were upset that this is not a typical Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-Tooie game. Banjo-Kazooie game is a platformer where you collect things. This game is a kart racer / puzzle game. With very, very little platforming elements. You can platform in this open world, but it's not like a Mario, it's not like Banjo-Kazooie. Banjo doesn't have many moves. He has jump, he has attack. Jump attack, and then regular attack. Another moves are being able to pick up things with the right trigger. So you can pick up that, and that's pretty much it. That's all his abilities. He doesn't gain any more, he doesn't lose any less. So compared to the endless, there's tons of abilities in Banjo-Kazooie. Like, having Kazooie come out and then sprint up things, or having him fly on certain points. That was really cool, but this is not that. And I think this might be a marketing thing. They knew that, hey, if we call this Banjo-Kazooie, it's gonna sell more. But I feel like it should have been called just Nuts and Bolts, and then have another character, because there is no relationship between, like, even the story has really nothing to do with Banjo-Kazooie. It uses the main antagonist, the witch Grieldra here. She's just sitting there. Like, it's just like, what? She's the main villain of this game, and she just sits there. So, the main villain, the antagonist, is this guy right up here who's bringing you back into this world to play video games. And it's 2008 too, and story, it's pretty limiting. I would really like to know how this game did as financially, and then, like, critically how it did, but it's really weird. You know, they even have, like, the jiggies, which are your puzzles, which are you collect for doing missions, and then you spit them out. It's really weird. Like, it's really fucking weird. You go into these worlds. Actually, first, you get these orbs, which are right there, right? That thing right in front of me. You get it from the big guy up there. What the fuck? Okay. Just like, I'm just fooling around here, and the frame rate's just complete awful garbage. It's just garbage. Garbage. So you first come in here, you get your orb, and then as you progress, as you get more puzzle pieces, you actually, he will give you more. You go down here, and then you drop them on these certain points, and then they open up worlds, and then open up portals to several worlds. So the sphere opens up the world, and then different portals open up different parts at different times of the world. It's not a great experience, and all that stuff. So let's see if I can get anything here. So we have puzzle pieces, trophies, notes, which are your currency now, and then the little creatures, and it's not a good experience. It makes me to think, like, oh, that rare play is kind of a cool thing. Maybe I can go back and play some of these good games. Games evolve, and you get adapted to the evolved game. So, like, going back to Fallout and New York, New Vegas is a little bit hard when you play. It's going to be really hard after you played Fallout 4, because Fallout 4 is going to be an amazing game. So, let's hear. So, you're dropped into this open world. First, you start your own little vehicle here that I have here, and throughout the game, it will be upgraded. But you can make your own. So let's see what I got here. Can I do anything from here? Okay. So I can get a trophy from here. So we start this. It's just like it's meaningless. Like, hey, this bomb dropped here, and then you can just hit skip, and it's just gonna tell you, hey, what you got to do. Sometimes this be a little bit vague. So what I'm gonna do is gonna lift the bomb. Oh, I can't change the vehicle. Oh, okay. Interesting. Okay, start. Damn it, I'm not gonna be able to get this. And there's even, like, a ready go. Like, it's a fucking kart racer. Press Y to get in, and I'm driving. And so I gotta get to my target over there. As fast as I can. Some missions will have preset, like this one, preset of vehicles. And then there's just mobs that just are around. You can destroy them. Like, they're like meaningless little obstacles that really don't mean anything. Like, I could still do my thing, and like, if something falls off, I just press right bumper, and it just magnetizes it back. Camera control is a little bit hard here, so... There's a light going on. Surprisingly, the controls are not that bad. Like, how am I supposed to get it into blue when I... There we go. And then that's it! So I beat by last time, so continue. I don't get anything from that, because I didn't beat this, and then there's like this little thing, whatever, and I come back here. Yeah, it's kind of like, I don't know. So let's get my vehicle, let's see here, heavy, light, heli, here we are. So the real premise of this game is that you build things, which is kind of cool. You're building little contraptions to figure out your goal. But again, it's like at the end of the day, it's a puzzle game, just like current games like Besieged, which is you create something to do, kill X amount of people. So let's see what other missions can I do here. So you can create airplanes, boats, hovercrafts, cars, tanks, and all sorts of different things, but it, like... I mean, over the course, you're gonna get more engines, bigger engines, and all that stuff. So what do we got here? What is this guy? So I already beat this. So this is a race. Again, fucking you're gonna encounter a lot of these races. This is straight-up kart racer, so just choose this vehicle. Actually, let's just create a vehicle. I got a new engine. We'll do something like that. Okay, so... you're gonna spend a lot of your time making vehicles, because it is fun! We're gonna, new vehicle, just clear that out. And, body? We'll do heavy, get some weight here. And make it a little bit wider in the back here. And that all. There's no kind of, like, indication of, like, because there's different gauges, so you get more power, you get more speed, you know, you get more weight, you know, all that stuff. So let's, we'll put the seat here, strong seat. There we go. Right there. And then we got different types of wheels. You first start off with high, and then, you know, each one has their own little different properties. Monster are good against uneven terrain, but they're also pretty, like, slow. Grip here, so we can... there, we do tons of these. Power, so we got a large engine. We go medium. And small. But then you need fuel. We'll do a couple of these. There we go. There doesn't seem to be much balance, so we'll do that. Storage is like a little tray you can have to put stuff in. There's a little bit of magnetization. Let's see. That, gadgets. Attachable, ejector seat, liquid squeeter, and bumpers, armor, floaties. So this way you get your wings. You can put wings to make it, first you can put on props where you can make a helicopter. It acts like a helicopter, with propellers. Or then you could put balloons, have balloons raise you up and then propellers pushing you forward. Or you can have wings, that is, it does pretty good. There's no yaw, which is your, turning left and right. There's, pitch, and then, roll. And then air cushion, you can make a, hover boat, and then floaters is this how you make a boat. You actually deploy them. And then all sorts of different weapons I've unlocked. You know, get one egg turret, egg gun, all sorts of other stuff, and then they do require ammo, and all that stuff. So it's like the building stuff is like really good and kind of like interesting, but like it's just a kart racer. So we're just gonna save this. Actually, how many engines did I put in here? I like to go MK and then how many engines? Power. I think I put 4. Yeah, 4, 7, 8. Yeah, let's go. Okay, 8. Oh, we can also test track, too. So, more engines, more speed. And then more fuel requires you can, you know, maintain speed for faster, for longer. Oh, man, I'm burning through that fuel. That's good. And then we'll do new vehicle. Confirm. Oh, fuck! Damn it! Oh, Jesus, I hit wrong button. We're gonna do that all over again. We can spin it out real fast. Actually, let's start out with this. Let's do that. Wheels. Grip. So grip are the standard ones you get will not. Oh, god damn it. We'll do that later. Power engine. Do the large one first. And then medium. God damn it, that's really fucking getting annoying. Oop. So you can see in the corner there, there's gauges, speed, fuel, ammo, weight, parts used. So that, the mediums, go right here, and then small. Actually, let's go that right there. And then fuel. Medium.
Bom, 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 bom.
Storage ammo. Okay, all that's good. And then we're gonna do seat. Strong. There we go. Bom, 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 bom. And then test it, make sure it works. There we go. There we go. Save. There we go. New. There we go. MK8 Racer. Go. Done. Blueprint saved. Let's get out of here. And then that. Like, you're gonna spend a lot of time building vehicles because it's really fun, but, like, at the end of the day, like, that's all you do in this game. That's all you do. Wow, he's actually on a bike. I never thought you could build a bike. So, I mean, it's... Of course, I'm, like, total overkill in this. You know, it is, the controls are a little bit floaty, the gravity is a little bit floaty. There we go, he's always like, ah, we wanted to go longer. You know, the whole game's about these missions. Even doing your little, I think they're jiggies or something, the little guys with the big noses, those are even missions. Some of them are race, some of them are, you know, go to here. And some of them are actually kind of broken. Like, one I encountered where, hey, go here. And then I went there and, like, I did it in, like, 7 seconds. Because it was supposed to, like, go up to the top or something. It was really confusing. Really not a fun experience. I feel like if they just called it Nuts and Bolts, maybe get away from the Banjo-Kazooie, it might have sold less, but it allowed them to, like, build a brand. And then maybe come back with a sequel to, you know, to tighten up a lot of the stuff that's in this game. Oh, no. So, cool. And that's, like, the whole game is just that. Like, it's very bare bones. But it's, like, at 2008, there's, you know, the Xbox 360 is about, what, 3 years old? I don't know. It's interesting. It's really you know, a show of its times and all that stuff. So how high can I go up here? There's stuff up here? Whoa! Hello. Whoa. Is there anything actually up here? Nope. Oh, wow, there actually is something up here. Huh.
see if we can get even higher.
Oh, field's running low. Oh no, the field's fine. Oh no, that's the end of the thing. Is there something up there? Nope. But yeah, that's it for Banjo-Kazooie in Action Replay. It's a good game. It does suffer from a little bit of frame rate when you're in the town. I don't know if that's part of Banjo-Kazooie, or if that's, if that's just a backwards compatibility. If it is the backwards compatibility, I really hope that it's not like all the backwards compatibility. You know, it is software, so it's a little bit harder to emulate. But it's a decent experience. You're gonna have fun with it. You're usually gonna dump in like 10 hours just building shit and fucking around. But like in terms of like, you know, this is a good game. This is a lot of fun, and you know, it's not really. The story is pretty dumb. You know, there's not much here. Like these worlds are kind of bare bones. Like there's nothing here. You know, it does look visually pretty good, but it's just like, you know, there's nothing here. Killing enemies yield no reward, so what's the point of killing them? Let's see here. You gotta hold Y to bring back your boat, you bring back your vehicle, but it's like... Let's see here. Let's just try to find a mob here, or an enemy. There's some of these challenges could be really hard. Like I just killed this guy and he yields nothing. Like nothing. What is the point of killing them? There we go. Okay, well that's it for to wrap this up before I start rambling on too much. That's it for Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts for Rare Replay. It's a pretty good, decent game. Anyways, as always, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.